Hello, my name is Lucy and today we start a course about data preparation. As you may already know, data transformation is a crucial part of data scientist's job, with up to 80% of their time spent on this task. However, despite its importance, there are not many data preparation courses that adequately demonstrate the complexity and the nuance of a good data preparation. Welcome to this course on data preparation. My name is Lucy Gunawan and I'm excited to be your guide throughout this tutorial. Today we will be using Anatella. Anatella is a powerful, fast, lightweight data science tool that allows you to learn data preparation easily. It handles billions of records of your laptop. It's a no-code ETL with a drag-drop interface. It's easy to use and fast to learn. In this tutorial, we will be using the TMDB 5000 movie dataset to answer some common questions about movies while learning to use Anatella step by step. We'll start with an easy question and gradually work our way up to more challenging ones, using the most common boxes to create a data pipeline. By the end of this tutorial, you will be able to answer questions such as what is the most popular movie, what are the top 10 movies released in 2016 based on popularity, what are the top 10 English language movies in 2015 based on the food average. Additionally, you will learn how to import data from a CSV file, inspect and explore the data extract, sort data based on the specific criteria, understand the basic data types in Anatella and convert between them, clean the data by replacing empty strings with null values, filter data based on the specific conditions, and finally export the data to a CSV file. This is just the content of the first course, but other will follow with even more exciting ways to extract the knowledge hidden inside your data. Let's download the data that we will use for the first tutorial. To do so, open Anatella, click on the Help menu, and select the first training about data preparation. Anatella downloads the datasets. You can see them here. Okay, let's get started. First thing first, let's organize our working space. We will create a folder called Tuto1 in our document folder and copy there the tmdbmovies.csv. Now, to import the data into Anatella, simply drag and drop the file into the workspace, and Anatella will automatically recognize the file. It's as easy as that. Once the data is imported, we can inspect it to see what we have. In each box of Anatella, you can view the data by clicking on the dot on the right side of the box. In this case, the dataset has 4,803 rows and 13 columns. This including fields such as movie ID, title, spoken language, budget, revenue, and more. If you want to inspect the content of a column, you can right-click on the box and perform a small audit. For example, we want to check the status field. We can see that the most of the movies in the dataset are released, but there are also some that are rumored or in post-production. Similarly, we can see that the most commonly spoken language in the dataset is English, followed by French. At times, it's useful to see the scope of the data we are working with. For example, we want to see the range of release dates. In order to do this, we can use the sort box. You can find most of the boxes on the right side of the workspace. Simply drag and drop the sort box next to the first box, and an automated connection will be established. In case the connection fails to perform automatically, we can manually connect the two boxes using the connector icon. Let's sort the data by release date in ascending order. Upon sorting the data, we can see that the release year of the dataset ranged from 1916 to 2017, though the year of 2017 is not fully represented yet. The thing to note is that you can always see the data for each box for each single transformation. This makes it easy to inspect the data and gain insights at every single step of the process. Anatella has three basic data types: key, floating point, and string or unknown. Key data type holds any positive integer up to 4 billion. Floating point data type, or double, contains positive and negative decimal numbers. String or unknown data type represents any data that is not numeric. Null is a special value that represents missing or undefined data. To change the data type, we can use change data type box. Optimizing data types can improve performance and reduce storage size. By the way, you can always refer to the help for a box by right-clicking the box with your mouse. The overview of the data type and its properties are in the section 5.1.2. For example, let's say we want to change the data type of our ID field from a string or unknown to type key data type. Once we make this change, the background cell of the ID field turns green, while the other fields remain white since they are still string. Next, let's change the popularity, budget, revenue, and score fields to the floating data type. Now, the background of these fields appear in blue, indicating their new data type. Additionally, we notice that there are white spaces in the data, which are not equivalent to null values. To make the data more compact and cleaner, we can use the replace string box to convert those white spaces to null values. As a result, some cell may now have a pink background. Cleaning up data is an essential step in data preparation, as it helps us manipulate the data more easily. Now we have cleaned the data, we can manipulate it to answer some questions that we have. For the first question, what is currently the most popular movie? To answer this, we can sort the data based on the popularity field using the sort box and sort the popularity in numerical order decreasing. We can see that Minion is currently the most popular movie with popularity score of more than 800. Let's say we only want to see the top 10 most popular movies. We can use the filter box and put the expression underscore n lower than 10. Keep note that in Anatella, the index starts with 0. Now, what if we want to know the top 10 most popular movies that were released in 2016? We can use another filter box and extract the year of the release date using the left function, then filter it for the year 2016. Let's give this filter a go. Now, let's apply another filter to pick out the top 10 result. Let's try another exercise. How can we find the 10 highest rated movies that are in English and were released in 2015? So the first step is to sort the data by vote average in descending order. Next, we'll apply filters for original language and release date. We'll need to use an AND operator for this. Finally, we'll apply another filter to select the top 10 result. Next, let's save the clean data to a CSV file and select only specific columns to be included, such as title, release date, and vote average. Now, let's take a look at the CSV file we created. To summarize what we have learned, we were able to import data into Anatella, inspect it, clean it, sort it, and filter it. We also learned about the basic data types and how to convert them to each other. Finally, we learned how to select a set of fields to be exported and export them to a CSV file. Don't forget to like and subscribe to see the next videos. See you next time!